Hey y'all, so I am about to hop on the road. It has been an awesome day and I'm also super, super exhausted. And I just stopped and did something that I do a lot, which is to take my emotional temperature. Now I know that might sound a little bit strange, so I'm gonna explain what I mean. But what I found is in order to stay encouraged, you actually have to first recognize that you need encouragement. And I know that might sound a little stupid or obvious, but there are so many times that we get to a point where we're completely exhausted physically and emotionally, or we're angry and frustrated and we feel like we're going to blow up. And we really could have avoided it if we realized sooner how we were feeling. So it's important to actually take your emotional temperature a couple of times a day. So it's something that I'll do whenever I feel like I'm not breathing. So one of my kind of ways that I know I need to stop and slow down is when I realize I'm going so fast and doing so many things that I'm not taking full breaths. When I can feel my blood pressure rising, like I'm getting frustrated, or like just now when I'm super excited to go fellowship with some ladies tonight, but I am exhausted and I just hopped in the car and I can feel myself like, oh, I'm so tired. That's when I need to actually stop and take my emotional temperature. Because even though I am physically tired, at the same time, I don't want to allow that to affect my emotions because I'm actually in a really good mood. It has been an awesome day, but I don't want my physical exhaustion to override how I feel emotionally and then make me feel like I can't emotionally take on what I'm going to experience tonight and have room to actually spend some time getting encouragement from other ladies and sharing encouragement with them. So I just want to encourage you to stop and take your emotional temperature a couple of times a day. When you first start doing it, maybe you set a couple of alarms when you first wake up around lunchtime and maybe around dinner time or before you go to bed, and just stop and think, how am I feeling? How am I feeling emotionally right now? And what is that related to? What parts of that are things I need to let go? And what parts of that are things that I actually am feeling good? And so I want to hold on to that. Sometimes you got to set an alarm for the first few times that you do it, just until you get into the practice of it. And then from there, you'll start to notice, what are those things? What are the ways that I can tell that my emotions are in a good place or a bad place? And then you'll start to just automatically saying, nope, I need to stop and take my emotional temperature, remind myself that everything is good, everything is okay, even if physically I don't feel that hot. So I hope that encourages someone out there. Stop a couple times a day, take your emotional temperature. I promise it will definitely help you, because you'll realize that you're much more in check with how you're feeling and you can deal with your emotions in that moment instead of letting them kind of build up and get to a place where they're bad or detrimental to you when you don't deal with them right at the moment. All right, y'all, take care and I will talk to you again soon.